So you want to know how to get stuff like this on your stream. I'm Rose Claire Chaos, and I'm here to teach you how to add stream stickers to your setup. First, you're going to want to add the stream stickers extension to your Twitch. It's super duper easy. Let's get started. Go to Twitch, click on that beautiful face of yours, and head over to Creator Dashboard. Tap the hamburger menu.
Hamburgers.
And scroll down to Extensions. If Twitch doesn't show stream stickers as a featured extension,
they should.
Type stream stickers in the search bar and hit enter. Now you should see stream stickers in the results. Click add, or if you went ahead and clicked it before I told you to,
you rebel.
Select install in the upper right and wait patiently. Once you see this graphic, click the activate drop-down menu and you can either add this as a component or a panel. There's a couple differences. A component is like a panel, but it overlays your stream while you're live, and a panel exists down in your about section. Choose whichever works for you the best. Now head back over to the extensions page, click stream stickers, then configure, and we're ready to start customizing. Once you see this graphic, you'll want to click open the dashboard. You might need to log in with your Twitch to access this, so go ahead and do that now, and I will wait. Say hi to this friendly little message.
Hi, how are you?
This gives you access to your browser URL. We'll come back to that later. Let's get to the fun stuff first. Stream Stickers does this awesome little walkthrough that helps you out just in case you don't see this video. There's a lot to go over in here, so let's start with setting up your sticker. On the sidebar, you'll see this cute little sticker icon. Go ahead and click it. This is where all the sticker goodiness exists. So Stream Stickers has already supplied you with a bunch of pre-populated stickers called Global Stickers. These will be enabled by default. Some of my personal favorites, or my chat's personal favorites, are the Rubber Chicken and the Whoopee Cushion. Great. Let's go over the Quick Adjust panel. Here you can mass edit settings like stickiness or how long a sticker stays on the screen. You can also edit things like volume and default bit amount. These global stickers are all really cool, but I find the secret sauce to the Stream Stickers recipe is custom stickers. Think of these like personalized emotes that your viewers can stick all over your screen. Keeping these fresh and new brings hype to the community, but it's also a way for you to have more creative freedom over your screen. Let me show you what I mean. Click the custom tab and fire up that creativity train. So you get 12 custom sticker slots to start, but don't worry. If you need more, you can unlock up to 36 sticker slots. Sticker slots unlock as chat uses stickers, so the more they slap, the more you get. To see how close you are at unlocking a slot, peep the status bar in the custom tab at any time. Now let's get uploading some custom stickers. Click that circle with the plus sign in any of those open custom sticker slots. Select the file you want to use for your custom sticker. Please note there are size recommendations for your files, so follow those for the best results. In this case, I'm using an awkward face turkey, which I call the awkward turkey. Once the sticker appears, click next. Pro tip number one, I find it's fun to let chat pick some of the custom stickers. This is a great way not only to connect with your community, but to customize your stream even more. For example, you can add stickers to trigger actions, like eating a sour candy on stream, which I would not recommend doing. Pro tip number two, if you want to give your image a sticker feel, use a 10-point white stroke around the outside of your image and make sure it's a transparent background. But if you need help with that, let me know in the comments and I'll help you out. Here you can upload custom audio to play when someone slaps a sticker. I'm using a turkey gobble to go along with my awkward turkey. That was a really bad turkey. But feel free to use any TOS-friendly WAV or MP3 file. You can listen to your sound effect by clicking preview audio. And if everything sounds great, click next. Go ahead and give your sticker a name. I'm going to name this awkward turkey and click next for the final step. And here's your custom sticker and your sound effect, ready to use as soon as you hit submit. Once you click submit, you'll see this message notifying you that your sticker was saved. Click okay. And here's your sticker. We did a great job. Each sticker has a set of custom options. Enable, disable, stickiness, volume, bits. And this little toggle, which lets you have sub-only stickers, which is pretty freaking awesome. As you upload more stickers, you can rearrange them in a custom order for your chatters by dragging that little icon in the upper right-hand corner. So we've tackled global stickers and custom stickers. Now let's take a look at reward stickers. These are unique from both global and custom because they unlock for your viewers as they use stickers. Think of this as giving your viewers a way of leveling up with stream stickers. It's important to note, since these do require bits, they are only available if you are an affiliate or higher. You can set these up the same way you set up the custom and the global stickers. Now that you have all your stickers ready to go, let's set up your sticker party. This is by far my favorite thing about stream stickers. A sticker party is a stream celebration where chat can slap as many stickers as they want to in 75 seconds for zero cost. Once you hit a certain stream stickers bit goal, the party initiates automatically. It is so much fun. On the side menu, click this little party icon. This is your sticker party settings page. From here, you can enable your sticker party, set your party meter bit goal, and set a sticker cooldown. I have mine set to 0 because I really like the chaos, but you can set yours up to 10 seconds. You can choose to enable or disable music, animated confetti, roll animations, and set a sticker limit, which is how many stickers can be slapped during the party. You can also have a sticker party meter appear on your stream so chat knows how close they are to kicking off a party. Now that we've set up your sticker party, let's get over to the chat bot. If you want to remind your viewers they can slap stickers and add a custom command, this is where you need to be. First, click that little megaphone on the side menu. Toggle this on to enable your chat bot. If you'd like, you can set up a custom message for your bot, or you can just stick with the default. Here, you can also adjust the minutes and the chat lines between posting, as well as create your command and your command cooldown. This is important. Don't forget to make stream stickers a moderator in your channel so the bot can post automatically. You can do so by clicking that button, or do /mod stream stickers in your channel. Now that we've finished adjusting all the settings, the only thing we have left to do is add the browser sources, and we are ready to go. Let's head over to your streaming software and finish this up. First, open up your streaming software. I use OBS, but you can use any software with the ability to add a browser source. Next, you'll choose whatever scene you want your stickers to appear in. For me, I want them in every scene, so I'm going to add them into my nested alert scene. Click the scene you want your stickers in, click this plus sign, click browser, and give your browser source a name. I'm going to name mine Stream Stickers. Then click OK. Here's where we're gonna need to add that browser URL. Now, there's a couple of places you can find your browser source URL. I find the easiest way is just to click the setup tutorial. A pop-up will appear with a large and in charge copy button. Just click that and paste it into your browser source URL box. Adjust your source to your output size. Mine is 1920 by 1080, but yours could be different. Then click OK. Now head back to the Stream Stickers dashboard to test your stickers. On the setup tutorial, click Next. Here you can test your setup. Nobody panic, you don't have to be live for this. Now click test sticker, sit back, and watch the magic happen. Important to note that this can also be done in the settings page, and I will show you that in a minute. Now you can test to make sure that your browser source is sized correctly by clicking test browser source size. The reason we want to test the browser source size is to ensure that the stickers cover your entire screen. You should see 4 purple triangles line up perfectly in the corners of the window. If you're happy with the way that looks, go ahead and click finish. We're gonna repeat this process one more time for your sticker party meter. One more time. Get your browser source ready, size it full screen, and head back to Stream Stickers. Go ahead and click that party icon again to get back to the party page. Here you can position your sticker party meter where you'd like it to appear on your stream. This will appear in the same source as your stickers by default. If you'd like your sticker party meter on a separate browser source, go ahead and toggle this on, copy your party meter URL, and add it as a separate browser source. I highly recommend adding your sticker party meter as a separate browser source so you can easily resize it and move it, or add it only in certain scenes. Now you should be able to see your sticker party meter on your stream. You can also do this process by clicking the gear icon and selecting the setup tab. Here you'll find all the same options, including your overlay URL, testing your stickers, and browser source size. Pro tip number 3. If you're using OBS, Stream Stickers gives you this handy dandy little drag and drop button that makes your life so much easier. All you have to do is drag and drop this into OBS and you are done. This properly sizes your source so you don't have to. It is pretty neato. While we're in settings, let's go over a few things. First, the General tab. Here you can adjust master volume, sticker cooldown, default settings for new stickers, and auto enable new global stickers. Also, Stream Stickers just released the ability to customize your panel theme. Now you can match your panels to your stream using a variety of supplied colors. You can also restrict where your stickers appear on your stream. For example, if you have a sub goal in the upper left and you don't want it covered by stickers, you can disable the upper left corner box by simply clicking it. Once you've started using Stream Stickers, you can check your activity feed in the Insights tab. This also shows you your leaderboard, bits activity, party activity, and your most popular use stickers. And there you have it. You are set up and ready to party. If you get stuck, you always have the option of clicking the setup tutorial, or rewatching this video, or joining the Discord and getting buckets of help from Stream Stickers. Again, I'm Rose Claire Chaos. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see what stickers you add.